When it came to the Galactic Empire, there was certainly no shortage of evil. Many times, the highest-ranking members of the New Order were viewed as the embodiment of evil itself, as they subjugated the galaxy to the unbending authority of the Emperor, with no room for disloyalty. But there was one Grand Admiral who would come to embody all of the worst elements of the Empire, and through his reign, would inflict upon the galaxy the worst acts imaginable, including slavery, rabid xenophobia, and genocide. In this video expose, I will explain the actions of Grand Admiral Danetta Pitta and describe why he was the most evil person in the entire Empire. During the era of the Empire, Danetta Pitta would rise through the ranks of the Imperial Navy, eventually being promoted to the newly formed rank of Grand Admiral 2 years before the Battle of Yavin, becoming one of the first 12 to receive the title. Prior to becoming Grand Admiral, Pitta became known throughout the galaxy for his fanaticism to the New Order and the Emperor, and also for his unrelenting hatred and bigotry towards non-humans within the Empire. In many ways, especially after his promotion to Grand Admiral, Pitta's xenophobia would come to define his legacy. Grand Admiral Pitta was an unrelenting proponent of an ideology known as human high culture. This wasn't unique among high-ranking Imperials, as many within the Commission for the Preservation of the New Order, or COMPNOR, promoted human high culture as well, and institutionalized it within its policies. Human high culture was a belief that viewed humans as inherently superior to all other species within the galaxy, with a core tenet being that humans were the true source of all innovations and production within galactic society. Many proponents of human high culture pointed to evidence, although debatable, that the Old Republic was mostly formed and led by humans, and that the human worlds of the core were some of the oldest and most advanced in the galaxy. After the establishment of the New Order, this view had been codified within the Empire, and supported by COMPNOR, resulting in severe discrimination and outright subjugation of non-humans across the Empire. For example, slavery of non-humans was re-legalized, only human-created works of art were accepted for production, and non-humans were discouraged from joining the Imperial military and political positions such as regional governors and moffs. Pitta wasn't unique in adopting these views in the era of the Empire, but even those within COMPNOR recoiled in disgust at just how far the Grand Admiral's fanaticism went. Pitta's beliefs manifested into extreme hatred for non-humans, to the point where even the strongest advocates for human high culture stayed away from him, viewing his bigotry as indefensible. Pitta's views may have been the result of the fact that he himself wasn't fully human, being a near-human that saw a shared ancestry with the Bornek and Eddie. But regardless, Pitta's views were as fervent as they were despite the true motivations, and sadly, his rise to the rank of Grand Admiral gave him the ability to unleash his twisted views upon the galaxy. Following his promotion, Pitta began a campaign that would place him as overseer of Imperial expansion within the Outer Rim. This, of course, was the official mandate of the campaign. In truth, Pitta was to oversee the depopulation and genocide of all non-human species they found during their mission, and given his prejudices, the Grand Admiral was the ideal Imperial to conduct this task. To assist his efforts, Pitta was given command of 3 dungeon ships, each with its own massive support group of Star Destroyers, which would sweep the Outer Rim and enslave, depopulate, and eradicate every non-human world they encountered. This cycle was completed on hundreds of planets, but the grisly details of exactly what these dungeon ships did was detailed by a survivor of Pitta's machinations on the Outer Rim planet of Gulma. At some point in Pitta's 6-year mission, the dungeon ship known as the Asgok landed upon Gulma. Led by Admiral Mir Torque and Chief Scientist Leonis Murthay, whose hatred of non-humans was matched only by Pitta himself, the Imperials rounded up the native species of Gulma, informing them that they were being removed from the planet for their own safety. In reality, once on board the dungeon ship, they were physically beaten and separated based on previously defined categories. The weak, old, and very young were placed within chambers and ionized immediately, killed in furtherance of Pitta's grand vision for the Outer Rim. Those who survived were granted little food, water, and sleep, but still forced to work in service to the Empire. Those who fell during the hard labor, or through the rages and bizarre experiments of Torque and Murthay, were simply placed into the fusion reactors that powered the ship. This process was conducted on hundreds of planets throughout the Outer Rim, decimating entire civilizations. This particular dungeon ship was only slowed when its escort group was recalled to fight in the Battle of Endor, and then permanently shut down by the rebels after the death of Palpatine. Pitta himself would survive Endor, using his position and wealth to commandeer the Empire's torpedo sphere, and rise to receive the title as protector of the Corellian sector. But he would ultimately perish a year later, killed by another former Grand Admiral named Joseph Grunger in the Battle of Tralis. But the actions and legacy of Grand Admiral Pitta during his rise through the ranks of the Imperial Navy, and especially during his six-year reign within the Outer Rim, could not be forgotten, and Pitta's actions represented the greatest evil unleashed by the Empire. So there we have it, why Grand Admiral Pitta was the evilest person within the Empire. We love making these videos, so why not subscribe for more fun Star Wars theories and discussions? Also, if you enjoyed the video, think about giving a like or leaving a comment. Or perhaps follow us on Twitter, @SWReadingClub, for updates regarding the channel. Or support the channel through Patreon, for access to exclusive rewards and discussions. If not for me... for yet another reason why Thrawn's such a badass.